treatment of pregnant women with epilepsy must balance the risk of seizures with the potential for adverse effects from the use of anti-epileptic drugs. In Denmark, we have seen a small increase in the use of anti-epileptic drugs among pregnant women in the last 10 years. The increase is only for the use of lamotrigine, while the use of the other anti-epileptic drugs has decreased. Several studies have found an association between the use of anti-epileptic drugs and congenital malformation, but only few have studied the association with spontaneous abortion and stillbirth. In Denmark, every citizen is assigned a unique personal identification number at birth. Using this number, we had the possibility to link different health registries and to get information on all pregnant women in the period from 1997 and until 2008, and to get information about their pregnancy outcomes and also the use of anti-epileptic drugs. We identified almost 1 million pregnancies in this period. About 110,000 of the pregnant women had a spontaneous abortion, and almost 3,200 experienced a stillbirth. 0.5% of the pregnant women used anti-epileptic drugs during pregnancy. In the group of women who used anti-epileptic drugs during pregnancy, we found that 16 out of 100 of the pregnant women had a spontaneous abortion, compared to 13 out of 100 in the group of women who did not use anti-epileptic drugs. After controlling for confounding, we found that the group of women who used anti-epileptic drugs, they had a 13% higher risk of spontaneous abortion compared to the group of women who did not use the drugs. It is possible that this increased risk could be because of the disease itself. Thus, we stratified our analysis according to the diagnosis of epilepsy. In the women who had a diagnosis of epilepsy, we found no association between the use of anti-epileptic drugs and spontaneous abortion. However, in the group of women who did not have a diagnosis of epilepsy, we found that the women who used anti-epileptic drugs, they had a 30% higher risk of spontaneous abortion. To control for unmeasured shared environmental factors and genetic predisposition, we made a sub-analysis where we only included women who had at least 2 pregnancies discordant for anti-epileptic exposure. And this means that they could, for example, be exposed in the first pregnancy, but not in the second pregnancy. In this analysis, we found no association between the use of anti-epileptic drugs and spontaneous abortion. We found no association between the use of anti-epileptic drugs and the risk of stillbirths, but we had only 18 stillbirths which were exposed to anti-epileptic drugs, so this has to be examined further in an even larger cohort.
The real strength of this study is that we were able to follow almost 1 million women during pregnancy. We studied a period over 12 years, and in this period we could not find an increased risk of spontaneous abortion associated with exposure to anti-epileptic drugs in pregnancy in women with epilepsy. We also studied the risk of fetal death, but we had too few cases to really study this in detail, but the information that we have do not suggest that there is an increased risk of fetal death associated with anti-epileptic drug exposure in pregnancy. There are some reservations with these observations, of course. These are based on registers, so we don't know whether the women actually ingested the medication, but we know that they reimbursed the prescription from the pharmacy. So in conclusion, we suggest that pregnant women with epilepsy continue their medication on the lowest possible dose. They should, of course, consult their doctor for other potential harms, including those of congenital malformations that has been previously shown to be associated with anti-epileptic drug exposure.